Hey guys, how's it going? And welcome back to episode number 5 of FIFA 19 Career Mode. And today, we have two games against Chamois FC. First in the Coupe de la Ligue, and then following that, we play them in Ligue 2. So yeah, let's head into the first game right away. Hopefully we can progress in the Cup, but we haven't had too much of a good start to the season. Hopefully we can turn it around a bit here though and get ourselves a victory. We're away from home. I think we're actually twice away from home today. So yeah, it's going to be a tough game. I think they're in fifth place in the league table as well. Here is their lineup. Let's have a look what formation they're playing. It is a 4-2-3-1 formation. It's a bit like ours, but like opposite, if you get what I mean. We've got those two midfielders are going to go on there. Midfielders, the wingers match, and then their attacking midfielder goes with our defensive midfielder. So it's a bit, I don't know, it's a bit like a matching formation, but not quite. Anyway, here is our lineup. As you might expect, except there are quite a few changes. Lech comes in at right back. Drow and Furtado also start. I think Loppy and Koita also played as well. Letalic starts up front, and Bauby gets himself a game in defensive midfield. But here comes Letalic. What can he do? He goes to Bauby. It comes back to Bauby. Now here it, and now he shoots. Oh! That wasn't too far wide. I think it was Loppy who played it back to him, and he's gone for the left-footed shot, and it's curving well away from the keeper, but unfortunately, it curves a bit too much. Goes out for a goal kick, and the score stays at 0-0 for now, but they have a throw-in, which is intercepted. Now here's Ziani, as we can look to come forward. Back to Loppy, but Loppy's given away, and he's been punished as well. Koyalipu is the goal scorer. Unfortunately, we've completely gifted them a goal there, and they go 1-0 up in the cup. Koyalipu is the goal scorer. We'll have a look at it on the replay, but there's not much else to say apart from that's not a good pass, but it's a good finish. I mean, Gallon might have been able to do a bit better than that, but it's powerful, really, from Koyalipu. It probably would have been saved by a goalie with higher reflexes, but unfortunately we don't have that. And it's 1-0 down, and now they're coming forward again. It's played through. Donna and Doe is faster than Edgar, and he's beaten him as well, and it's played in. Oh, that was a very important block from Deprino, denying the attacker. Who is it? Digler. I think his name's Digler. Anyway, it goes behind for a corner, which they're going to take now. In it goes. It's laid off. Here's Kilama. What can he do with it? He looking to find a shooting opportunity. Now it's played back to Paro. Out to, no, it's not Digler, it's Jiggler. I suppose the D is silent, but that shot, I mean, that header goes over the bar. But now we have a corner. Can we find something here? It's headed away. Only as far as Koita. What can he do? He beats his man nicely there. He takes the shot on. It's blocked. Comes right back to him. We're working a bit of space. Here's Bauby. Bauby shoots, saved by the keeper. And they get it away. Bauby's had two efforts so far in this game. That one better than the first, but neither of them have found the back of the net. And okay, we're coming up to half-time as Lech makes that intercept. And here is Koyalipu as they look to score just before half-time. Riverian. I don't know how you say that name, but that shot is wide. And it goes behind for a goal kick, which I think may well be the last action of the half, especially as we lose that header. And yeah, there it is, half time. 1-0 down at the break, unfortunately. Hopefully we can turn it around, though. We have had a few decent opportunities. We just got to take one and be more clinical in this second half if we want to get ourselves through in the cup. We'll head into the second half. Are we going to make any substitutions? We're going to bring on DeMonsi for DePrino, actually. And yeah, let's hope that this team can go and get us through. And through in the cup. And it's come out to Furtado. No, it's not. We've got a corner, though. What can we do from this corner? Ziani is on it. He goes to the edge of the box where Dro is waiting. He goes to Bauby. Will he shoot? He will. It's blocked. Edgar has a shot. Oh, it's saved this time, though. That would have been some finish if that flew in top corner. But now it's kicked upfield, and there's only 12 minutes left now. There's not been much highlights in this second half. And here is Perrin. What can he do? He turns nicely. There's space on the far side. Jordan Tell! Oh my goodness, how has he missed that? He shoots and it's blocked and it's wide. How has he missed that? There was another dude over the other side as well. I mean, he's managed to kick it straight into the person lying on the ground. And now the cross comes in. That should be keeper's ball. It's punched away. Bowby's going to get there. He comes inside. Edgar. DeMonsi. What can he do? Looking to find a bit of space, but he gives it away. And no, we've won it back through DeMonsi. Furtado. Holding it up calmly. Bowby. Into DeMonsi. And here's Letalic. Plays it into Furtado. He looks for the cross. It's blocked. Cross again. Straight at the keeper. And again we cannot find ourselves a goal. And now they're coming forward looking to seal it. Jigler. It's blocked. But it falls straight to them. Here's Koyalipu. He's got it through. And he scored. And we're out. And after all that attacking opportunity for us, they've gone and scored, fortunately, on the counter-attack. It comes over to the far side. I mean, I think, who's that who's come across? It might be Dro who's come across to try and get that block in. But he can't. Gallon again, not making a good set, being able to make a save. And Koyalipu has scored two, and he's probably knocked us out of the cup. We are still coming forward. Can we find something here? It comes out to Koita. He turns. He does nicely there. Can he find something? Its shot is blocked, unfortunately. And there's just 40 seconds left of normal time. Gallon is up. Can it find him? No, it's headed away. Dro is on the ball now, though. Goes to Bauby. His cross is blocked. Headed down, trying to pass away. Bauby kicks it against one of their men. It bounces in the air. They bicycle kick it clear. Oh, it's a good tackle, though. Okay, so he's given a foul for that tackle and a yellow card. I cannot see how he's that blind. I'm, like, 90% confident that Tell made a good tackle there and kicked the ball. But I don't know what the referee has seen as they kick it up forward. It's headed back towards Chamois' goal. I mean, our goal, Chamois' forward line, and there is full time. We go out of the cup with a 2-0 defeat, unfortunately. But will we be able to turn it round and get revenge on them in this next game against the same opposition in the league? Hopefully we can, although we haven't picked up a single point so far this season in the league. Hopefully that will change right now, though. But that was not a very good performance. We go out of the cup. 2-0 is the score. And yeah, not very good. But anyway, have a look there. They are fifth leading into this league game. We are 19th, yet to pick up a point. Hopefully that will change after today's game. Again, we're away from home, like I thought. And we're going to go with the same... actually, it might not be the same lineup. We'll have to have a look. It was somewhat the same. But here we go. It's a rainy night in Chamois. Or if that, I hope that's a place. Otherwise, that's completely incorrect. But anyway, Ziani is in the team, I saw, and they've got a similar team to last time. Same goalkeeper. I recognise Rivierian, Kilama as well. Same formation. Koyalipu, of course, who scored those two goals. Dona and Doe, I think, played. But there's a few changes. I think we've made a few changes as well because of fitness reasons. But yeah, we'll have a look at our lineup. Gallon keeps his place. Monfray comes back in, as do Cambon and Mutombo. Pinot gets back into the side. Avunu as well. Efestian. Deprino is one of three players to keep his spot, along with Telenziani. Perrin starts today over Koita. And let's see if we can pick up a win today. Although, no, make no mistake, I would definitely take a point against fifth place when we've had such a poor start to the season. But a win would be wonderful nonetheless. Here's kickoff. We're going to start a bit defensive. And let's see if we can pick up a win. But here, they're coming forward early on. Emeka Atachung. Sorry, Emeka Atachung crosses and it's a penalty has been given. And it's a yellow card as well. I'm not sure about this one. Cambon has tried to slide in and block the cross. He's got nowhere near it. And then that dude has ran into him as he's on the ground. And fallen over him, and it's a penalty. I mean, I don't know. It looked like he just slid straight. Which means him, it might have been, he might have just run into him, try and get the penalty, but he slotted it away nonetheless. It's 1-0. Gallon can't save it. He thought he was going down the middle. Unfortunately, he went a bit to the right, and it's 1-0 down. We trail once again. We trail once again early on. It's actually not a very good penalty, and he was lucky that Gallon didn't dive. And after that, we're 1-0 down. It's just not going very well this season. After the preseason tournament, everything has fallen apart completely, it seems. That's Dona and Doe's third, I think it was, goal in the league. Let's see if we can bounce back, though. Come on, lads. Here's Ziani. Takes it round Konate, and he's got the right side of him as well. He gets the cross in. Perrin's at the back stick. Perrin, oh, he's missed. Oh, that was a good opportunity. Oh, he's hit the post. Goodness me. He tried to just place it in with that left foot, but he couldn't find the back of the net. And now they're coming forward again, looking to make it 2-0. Louisier. Oh, Dona and Dovitz played in. Emeka with Atachunga, I think his second name was. But it's a great block that stops them from going 2-0 up. And now Perrin to Deprino as we look to find an equaliser. It's played into Tell. Tell turns. Tell shoots. Goal! Yes, there we go. Our first goal in the league. Actually, I can't remember if we scored. No, I think it is our first goal in the league for a while. Although I could be completely wrong. Maybe it's just the one game, and then we had the cup game as well where we didn't score. But Jordan Tell has scored nonetheless. It's 1-1, and that's just what we want to see. It's a nice turn inside. He cuts back, leaving that defender for dust. And it's a very good finish as well on his left foot. Don't know if he's left or right-footed. But that is some finish. Very well positioned. Very well timed. Very well struck. It's a very good goal indeed from Jordan Tell. Much better than that effort he had in the cup. That would have equalised the game. Somehow missed from inside the... The small box is the 6-yard box. He somehow missed from inside the 6-yard box. But now... Oh, Perrin's given it away, unfortunately, though. But he might be able to win it back, and he does. He loses it again, but he wins it back again. Very well done from Perrin. Now Deprino, looking to slot in Perrin. Can Perrin find a good delivery? Oh, he turns nicely. He finds Tell. Tell shoots, but he couldn't quite direct it in on the turn. And almost we took the lead just before half-time. Unfortunately, though, Tell's shot just curling a bit too much. And it goes wide. Oh, here they come forward at the very end of the half. Hopefully we don't let them score. Emeka Atachunga is on the ball now. Cross is blocked, though, by Cambon. And as Avunu passes it away, there is half-time. It's 1-1 at the break. We've not done too badly in that first half. Cambon's brain lapse was a negative part of it. But apart from that, I think we have been the more dominant team, which is a surprise. And it's also very good news. Almost could have had a two-goal lead. We hit the post, of course, with Perrin and then Tell missing that goal as well. But here they come forward. 65 minutes. We're 20 minutes into the first half of the second half, I mean. And the first highlight comes and it's a good shot. But thankfully, it goes over the bar. And now, here we're coming forward. Here's Ziani. What can he do? He goes to Tell. To a Festian. To a Vunu. To Tell. He evades that slide tackle and evades another. And it's through. Avunu, chance to win it, maybe. Oh my goodness, he couldn't have missed by much further. That was very unlike the good finish he made in the preseason tournament on his left foot from a similar circumstance. He's put that one about 20 metres wide of the left-hand post. And now, just before the end of the game, they're coming forward in an attempt to steal a point from us. It's a good tackle by Avunu. Maybe we can do that to them and get 3 points. Perrin coming forward. Oh, it's given away. And now they could do it. They've got one last chance. Emeka Atachunga inside to Burhane. Across to Kogalipu. His shot is blocked by Pinot. It's coming inside again. Shot on the edge of the box. Oh my goodness me. It's gone wide. That would have been a very bad goal to concede at the end of the game. He could have smacked that in and given them 3 points. Thankfully, he didn't, though. And we get away with our first point of the season. I think we'll take that. Fifth place away and we get a point. Yeah, that's pretty good if you ask me. Jordan Tell gets the goal. Well done from him. And the game ends with the score at 1-1. Very good indeed. I thought we played pretty well. Could have easily won it as well. Although they could have easily taken it at the very end. But we still are in 19th place after... Who was right bottom with us? It might have been Clermont Foot. But they picked up a victory. As you can see there, they beat Le Havre. And they're up there as well. So that's they're in third place. That's a very good result for Clermont Foot. They were undefeated before Clermont Foot came along and beat them. That's a good result for them. Not so much for us as we stay in 19th place. Thankfully, Red Star still haven't got a single point this season, so we're still above them. But yeah, playoffs are looking ever less likely this season. Oh, okay. I'm looking at that. There's only 2 playoff spots. And if I remember correctly, there's a relegation promotion playoff in France. So that means, I think that would mean 3rd and 4th play each other. And the winner of that gets to play the team who finished 18th in League One. And the winner of that stays in League One or goes to League One. But there you saw we rejected an offer for Cambon. Here is another one. This one from Norwich and for less money. So I'm pretty sure we're going to reject that again. Yes, we do. Cambon, 67 rated. He might be getting old, but he's definitely worth more than that. And now we've got an offer for Monfray, which is negotiable. But definitely not in the region that we are looking for. Querétaro from Mexico want to try and take him. And we'll see what they think. Hopefully we can get a decent amount of money for him. Otherwise, we'll just not sell him because he's a decent right back. And he's 27, so he's still got plenty of years left in him. And he's value is less than what they're offering. No, his value is more than what they're offering. And we're going to look to get him for $1.2 million and see what they think of that. Hopefully they'll accept it, get a lot more money into our bank account, get that up with the $3 million target, of course, in mind. But they only want to pay €510,000 for him, which is not nearly enough. I mean, I might sell him for $900,000, $800,000 or something like that, but not for $510,000. And we decide to reject that offer from Querétaro. The Mexicans will not be having Monfrey, and yeah, that's not happening. We're keeping our squad for now, but that'll be it for today's episode. I hope you have enjoyed. If you did, please do drop a like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye.